Network uptime is a critical factor for industrial networks. Industrial network redundancy protocols like MRP provide networks with very fast recovery times in the backbone ring, but they offer no protection at all against loops in other parts of the network. For this reason, loops are a very common cause of failures in industrial networks. So let's look at how you can mitigate them in your network. While redundancy protocols like spanning tree work well in an office environment, they lack characteristics which are essential in an industrial environment. Let me give you a couple of examples. First, the mesh topology, which is commonly used with spanning tree, is often not practical for industrial networks. Second, industrial applications are time sensitive and they cannot tolerate the slow or unpredictable recovery times, which are typical of office redundancy mechanisms. This is the reason why industrial networks typically use standardized or proprietary ring-based redundancy protocols. The great strength of these ring-based protocols is their physical simplicity, plus their ability to recover from the failure of a physical link quickly and predictably. But these industrial protocols have a weakness. They only protect the ring itself. They do not protect your network against loops occurring somewhere other than the ring. And yet, the non-backbone ports are where these destructive loops are most likely to occur. You might have considered trying to resolve this problem by combining office and industrial redundancy protocols. For example, running spanning tree protocol over MRP. But this is difficult to configure and it's not always reliable. It can result in incompatible redundancy mechanisms competing against each other, and this can lead to further network downtimes. Loop detection is a tried and trusted mechanism for detecting and temporarily closing loops, and it works seamlessly with the industrial redundancy protocols you are already using in your network. Compared with the complexity of implementing spanning tree over MRP, loop detection is simple to configure. You don't need to spend hours planning it. Just enable it on the non-backbone ports of your switches and you are done. Loop detection is a simple protocol which works independently of other redundancy mechanisms. This means you will not have to deal with network instability caused by two redundancy protocols conflicting with each other. You may choose to deploy unmanaged switches at the edge of your network to reduce the initial cost. But unmanaged switches offer no protection at all against loops. By activating loop detection on your managed switches, you can compensate for a loop on an unmanaged switch, which would bring down the rest of the network. If your network does not have protection against loops and a loop occurs, it's unlikely that you will be able to connect to the management agent of the switches to locate the fault. So you will need to waste time walking around your network unplugging cables until you find the loop. With loop detection, you can find the loop from the comfort of your desk, which means your network will be back to normal operation in the shortest possible time. Even though loop detection is simple to implement, it has many deployment options to protect your network. In the following examples, loop detection is enabled on a single switch. This is to show you the loop scenarios that a single switch can protect itself against. It's important to point out that in normal operation, you would activate loop detection on all switches. First, a loop on the switch itself. Loop detection will block one of the ports. Second, a loop between the switch and another switch. Again, loop detection will block a port. Third, a loop somewhere else on the network. Yet again, loop detection will block the port in the direction of the loop. To be clear, loop detection will not protect your network from very short loops. Short loops are the trade-off for simplicity. But loop detection will provide a window of opportunity for you to fix the problem before it leads to a network failure. By enabling loop detection on your network, you are adding another layer of protection. This will result in higher availability for your network and the applications running on it. So, if your Ethernet switches already support loop detection, it makes sense to use it. If it's not available, then next time you buy an industrial Ethernet switch, make sure it offers loop detection.